there are still a few more things we can do with this picture or graphic. If we turn on our frame toolbar, going into View, Toolbars, Frame, I'm going to bring this one down low and this one up high. Okay, we're going to skip over this first part for now and go right into the wrap. We've seen the wrap off and we've seen the wrap page, but here's one we haven't seen yet, wrap through. And it lets the text go underneath our graphic. For this, we might want to turn on our transparency, maybe to about 80. And now it's almost like a watermark. Let's turn the wrap off. And these next three we've seen before, the left, center, and right justify. And that works with the page wrap on or off. These next icons, this top, center, and bottom, these actually have to do with the anchor that we saw earlier. I said we'd come back to. We're going to start talking about that right here. If we look at our picture, we look at our anchor, it says I'm anchored to the paragraph. And we see our anchor at the top of this paragraph. So now we know when we click the top, it'll take us to the top of the paragraph. This will put us in the center of the paragraph. And clicking the bottom will take us to the bottom of the paragraph. If we change this anchor to page, it will take us to the top of the page. And I might want to zoom out a little bit to see what it looks like. Top of the page, center of the page, and bottom of the page. Next thing we have is the borders, and we've got the border style and thickness. We can make it thicker. We can make it a dashed or dotted line. Change the color to maybe blue. And then the background color, we'll make this red. And bring the front and center back. What that is we'll need another graphic in here. We can see how the second graphic is over the first graphic. Click on send it back, and now the regular logo was in front, bringing it to the front. So that's the bring to front, send to back. And we already looked at the change anchor.